I'm gonna show you how to post your reels using a desktop computer and three free tools, Canva, CapCut, and Instagram. Call me an elder millennial, but I would way rather type than text. If you're the same, let me show you how you can get off your phone and produce reels and TikTok way faster by using your desktop computer. Here I am on Instagram.com, and did you know that there is a create button right here so you can literally post from your desktop using Instagram.com. All you need to do is drag the file that you want to post over onto Instagram. This one looks good. What's that? How did I create this file in order to post it on Instagram.com? Well, we need to rewind a few steps. The first tool I'm going to show you that you're probably familiar with as an online entrepreneur is Canva.com. Canva makes it super easy for you or your team members to create a reel all on desktop. So the first thing you're going to do is go to create design. And then if you scroll down, you're going to see this Instagram reel template. And I recommend going down to projects and then folders and creating a folder that's called B-roll clips of yourself. So B-roll are those little moments where you are walking or taking a call or working at your desk. And once you get into the habit of filming B-roll and creating a collection, it's going to make making reels so much faster. So in this case, I've got a couple clips, and let's say I choose this one right here, and I'm going to position it so that it covers my entire template here. And you can see that the way I filmed it, I left a lot of blank space where the blue sky is. That's intentional because we can add text on top. Now you want to look down at the bottom here and you can see the duration of your clip. If you wanted to trim it, you would just mouse over to where you see this little arrow icon, and then you can drag it to make it shorter or longer. Now there's also audio. So if you wanted to turn that off, you would just go to this volume button here and turn it off completely, which I recommend because when you post this, you're probably going to overlay some cool trending music. All right. So really the next and last step we need to do is head over to this text column here. And I like to choose add heading, and this is going to be our text on top. So this is really small initially. So let's boost it so you can see. And this is where I recommend hooking people's attention because this is the text on screen. We want to grab people's attention instantly so that they know this is for them. Let's use this sort of hook where it's like, POV, you're a new mom and entrepreneur who wants to work less. So this is a hook that I'm seeing around Instagram, right? So you're basically calling out, you're describing yourself and you're calling out your audience. And then you end it with, and you find this account. That's the POV, that's their point of view. And then we can add one more blurb of text saying, we wanna drive people to the caption. Now this text, maybe we want to pop, make it pop a little bit more. So we head to effects here. We can add a shadow. We can change the color of the shadow as well so that it stands out a little bit. This text, maybe we want to change the color of it entirely. We've got some brand colors here that we can work with. Let's go back to effects. Let's see if we can add a background. We can add a background. Here's the color of the background. Okay, let's go back to our text color and make it stronger. There we go. So you can play around with it more. You can change the font if you'd like, but definitely make sure that you are within those boundaries that we saw pop up. And also definitely make sure that you're turning the audio off. That is something you can change and edit in the Instagram app when you're publishing, but this is just easier. So this reel is good to go. We're going to then head to share and then download, and we are going to keep it as an MP4 video, but you can see that there's many options here as well. Quality, let's make it as high possible as we can, and let's hit download. So this is going to take a little longer to download because I upped the quality. So while that downloads, let's head to the second free desktop tool, which I love and I actually use more than Canva. It's called CapCut. I love CapCut because it is a free app that's connected to my TikTok account. And then when I downloaded the desktop app of CapCut, it's connected to my CapCut account still. And what's really cool is I can start creating and editing projects on my phone. And then there's a magical button that will sync them to my desktop. So this project right here is one that I actually started to create on my phone, but I synced it and brought it over to my desktop so that I could finish it. Now this is the homepage, and here under spaces, this is where I can see those projects that are linked to my phone. Going back to home, we are going to tap new project, and we are going to import a video, a clip. So again, this is where we need that B-roll. So this clip right here, which I have saved on my computer. We're going to import that into CapCut. Next step is to drag the file over to our editor. We are going to bring it all the way down to, this is 6 seconds, looks good. And again, we heard the beautiful sounds of the ocean. So if you head right over to this sound icon, we can actually mute the clip. So if you go to this music tab, you can see that there's tons of musical options by category, right? Travel, vlog. But if you go to this TikTok tab, this is where you can find your saved music. So we're just gonna drag it down to our creation area. And you can see that this song has a nice drop. So when I'm designing this reel or TikTok, it could be both, a drop in the music when the beat drops or changes like that, that's a really good place for you to expose your text or show a new message, something like that. So we've got our clip, we've got our music, now we have to add our text. That's the last step. So we go over to this column right here where it says text, and you can see that there's tons of options. I keep it simple, I go with what's trending, and I really like the white and black text because it's just easier to read. So we're gonna hit this one, all right? And now we're gonna drag it over on top. Okay, so, and this is where we're gonna edit it. Select your text, and then you can drag it down to the sand, and you can also minimize your font size right here. We need like a really good message for that drop, and we only really have one line to make that message happen, because if we go any further, we're gonna overlap with the elements of Instagram. So let's think, what's the punchiest thing we can say? What I wish more coaches realized. You can add some text that's going to come in when this drop hits, right? So we've got this second line of text. It's going to be below right here. And then right here, I'm going to edit it to say, you gotta show your face. Some people might be intrigued. They might be confused by this message. So I'm actually going to add a additional line of text. So let's move this up to here. And we're gonna add one more line of text, maybe something very bold, like the red. And let's just say simply more in caption or something like that, or read the caption. Again, we just have to be super aware of those borders and boundaries. Whether we're posting this on TikTok or Instagram, you don't want it to be too close to the edges. All right, so this is our beautiful, beautiful reel, if I do say so myself. Let's play it full screen. So why I thought of this punchy message, you gotta show your face, is because I'm seeing a ton of faceless reels right now, which might work for some niches, but not for coaches. So this is what I wanna talk about in my caption. Regardless, this video is about editing on desktop, and this reel is done. And speaking of which, when we hit export, which is right here in the upper corner, you can play around with the codecs and the settings here, but let's just hit export and it's done. Let's just look right here. There we go. Now notice with this file, there is no watermark. It doesn't say anywhere that it's made in CapCut or related to TikTok. So what this means with this file, you can actually publish this on TikTok, on Reels, on LinkedIn, on Pinterest, on X, formerly known as Twitter, on all the places, because there's no watermark. This is the power of this tool. And when you're in the flow of creating videos like this, you can bang out probably 10 of these in an hour, no problem. So this is how you get way more efficient with your Reels creation. Now, making Reels, typically something you do on your phone, on my desktop, was a key part of how I took 4 months off my business and still made over $280,000. If that's something you'd like to do for yourself, watch this video next.